Welcome back to The Search is Over, an iGEMS TV podcast. I'm John Fitzgerald and happy to be your guide to engaging movies and series. This week, we finish off our countdown to Halloween with a list of our top 10 horror films of all time. An Emmy Award-winning series returns for its much-anticipated second season, and an acclaimed drama from this year's Toronto International Film Festival comes to streaming. So let's start there, and kick things off with The Good Nurse. An overburdened ICU nurse leans on her selfless new colleague at work and at home, until a patient's unexpected death casts him in a suspicious light. Eddie Redmayne gives a chilling lead performance in this gripping drama based on the real-life serial killer who used his position as a nurse to murder dozens of his patients. Here's the trailer.
Hey!
What's going on?
Just, you know, work's been pretty awful without you there. You and I were partners.
I know, I don't want to talk about work.
Is it because what they're saying is true?
So, how are the girls?
They're really good, but I'm working a lot.
You still owe me for last Friday, but it can wait, really.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No. There's 50. Sorry about that.
Thank you. Bye, Mom. Love you guys.
Nurse Loughran, this is Officer Braun.
Do you remember Anna Martinez?
There you go. Yeah.
Her death.
It was sudden.
Mind taking a look at this?
The insulin in her system, it's a double medication error, which is really rare.
We understand that you work with a Charlie Cullen. Could he be involved in this?
Hey there, lovebirds.
I cannot get over how cute your Vanessa is.
Who's Vanessa?
Oh my God. There's insulin in her system.
Code number 103. Code number 103.
He's been at 9 hospitals. 9.
What do you mean? No, the hospital would have done something.
You would think so.
Yeah. Do you remember working with someone named Charlie Cullen?
Yeah.
There was a rumor about him. They found insulin in a dead guy's saline bag. Hey, girls.
Yeah.
Come, sit.
Why are you being weird, Mom?
You could see The Good Nurse on Netflix. Next up, Stars at Noon. A young American journalist stranded in present-day Nicaragua seduces an enigmatic Englishman who seems like her best chance of escape. Soon she realizes, though, that her torrid affair has only put her in more danger. Based on the acclaimed Dennis Johnson novel, French director Claire Denis's adaptation is enigmatic, vibrant, and visually stunning, as is always the case with this amazing director, with terrific performances from Margaret Qualley, Joel Alwyn, and Benny Safdie. Here's the trailer.
Where are you from?
I'm an American journalist. I came here as a special correspondent. And what about you?
I'm here alone.
We have 45 minutes till the bar closes. Long enough to get swacked.
Should we meet again? I'm here on a charitable cause.
Please don't go into detail. Who's that friend of yours?
What I do interest.
He's waiting for you outside of the hotel right now.
This country is kind of like a gambler's paradise. Everybody's giving the odds a shake, whichever game they feel like playing. Your British friend interests me. How long have you known him? How do you know he is who he says he is?
I could just snap my fingers and envelope of $20,000. in your lap like that.
What did you do?
Things aren't as simple here as you want to think.
You're gonna get us both killed.
What brought you here? What are you, Moses?
I wanted to know the exact dimensions of hell.
So many dreams we share, like the stars.
You can see Stars at Noon on Apple TV, Google Play, Vudu, or Amazon. And finally, Louis Armstrong's Black and Blues. This documentary honors Armstrong's legacy as a founding father of jazz, one of the first internationally known and beloved stars, and a cultural ambassador of the United States. The film shows how Armstrong's own life spans the shift from the Civil War to the civil rights, and how he became a lightning rod figure in that turbulent era. Director Sasha Jenkins crafts a wonderful tribute to Louis Armstrong as both one of the defining musical artists of the 20th century and his importance as a beloved African-American figure amidst the emerging civil rights movement in the 1960s. Here's the trailer.
Do you think you've lost by being born black in a white country?
No, I don't look at it that way.
The greatest influence in jazz of all time, Louis Armstrong.
Old empty bed.
Jazz almost stems from Louis Armstrong.
Wished I was dead. What did I do?
Anybody who has uttered a sound on American radio,
so black and blue.
It's because of Louis Armstrong's innovations.
He never would come out publicly, but at home he had his opinions.
I've heard recordings of Pops just talking. He understood there was a battle in this country.
I don't have no flag, other than a black flag.
That's right.
There's a rumor that you invented scat singing.
It came to me just like that.
To be black in those days, the discrimination was unbelievable.
His own inner dignity was able to make him prevail over all these awful conditions he worked with.
What did I do?
He was the first black movie performer to have his name above the title.
I do.
He was trying to use his music to reform and lead the country closer to its higher ideals.
Arkansas had decided to make its own laws on the subject of integration.
Louis said Ike and the government could go to hell.
Everybody was astonished, but privately, he expressed stuff like that all his life.
My only sin,
all over the world,
is in my skin.
He had the respect,
they laugh at you,
and the love of millions.
And scorn you too. What did I do?
What more can any man ask for?
To be so black and blue.
You can see Louis Armstrong's Black and Blues on Apple TV. On the series side, we kick things off with The White Lotus. The new season of the acclaimed anthology series leaves Hawaii behind and follows a different group of vacationers as they jet to another White Lotus property in Sicily and settle in temporarily amongst its inhabitants. Creator Mike White's sharp satire of wealthy vacationers is just as fresh in the show's second season, with a terrific ensemble cast including Michael Imperioli, Aubrey Plaza, and F. Murray Abraham. Here's the trailer.
Whenever I stay at a White Lotus, I always have a memorable time. Always.
Welcome to the White Lotus in Sicily.
La Dolce Vita.
You guys are here to learn about your Sicilian roots. Sounds like a fun boys' trip.
Wasn't supposed to be a boys' trip.
We're on a family vacation right now, and it's just the three of us, because all the women in our family hate you.
Please, can we just drop it?
Now that he's loaded, you think he regrets marrying such a dud?
What is going on with you?
There's a reason they invited us here.
It's like you sold your company, you got rich, and now he's your best friend.
Are these the kind of people we're gonna be hanging out with now?
Did you vote, babe? Be honest.
I did. Didn't I?
Doesn't matter.
Flirting is one of the pleasures of life.
You're 80 years old.
But the women I desire remain young. You can relate to that.
I just wanted to inform you that my good friends here, they're going to be visiting me this week, coming and going.
They come and go.
See you later. Bye.
I see.
You bring your assistant to a vacation with your husband.
It's not like she's going to be in our bed and stuff. I don't know what's going on with Greg, but I think it's bullshit. I think he's having an affair.
I've seen a lot of guys who, like, make all this money and they just start acting different.
You guys party?
What happened last night?
Just been a series of very bad decisions.
You've had very bad luck.
The best thing about luck is it can always change.
Italy's just so romantic. You're gonna die. They're gonna have to drag you out of here.
You could see The White Lotus on HBO Max. Next up, Guillermo del Toro's Cabinet of Curiosities. Bizarre nightmares unfold in 8 tales of terror in this visually stunning, spine-tingling horror collection created by Guillermo del Toro. This acclaimed filmmaker hosts an excellently curated horror anthology series with entries directed by some of the most exciting and diverse voices in the genre today, including David Pryor, Jennifer Kent, and Anna Lily Amirpour. Here's the trailer.
Picture your mind as a cabinet where you lock up your darkest thoughts and deepest fears. What would happen if you opened that cabinet for the world to see? We are about to find out. Picture your mind as a cabinet where you lock up your darkest thoughts and deepest fears. What would happen if you opened that cabinet for the world to see? We are about to find out.
This is one of those nightmare specials, the kind you never get to the bottom of.
What was this family doing here? One on the walls.
Lot 36. Are you curious?
Whatever is in there is mine now. I've seen a forest. A forest that takes the dead inside.
Joyce, see my paintings.
Please, show me mercy.
No!
Welcome.
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 Welcome to my Cabinet of Curiosities.
You can see the Cabinet of Curiosities on Netflix. And finally, From Scratch. Amy Wheeler, an American student studying in Italy, meets and falls in love with Lino, a Sicilian chef. When Lino faces health issues and the couple's future is threatened, the two families come together. Inspired by Temby Locke's best-selling memoir of the same name, this romantic limited series is a delight to watch from start to finish, with beautiful Italian landscapes and a strong central romance between leads Zoe Saldana and Eugenio Mastrandrea. Here's the trailer.
In Italy, we have a saying, in dreams, as in love, all is possible.
Cercavo una donna e ho trovato.
Where are you from? Texas? I came here to experience art, to try things I may never get to again in my life. Oh. Mi chiamo Amy.
Sei americana?
Sì.
Allow me to cook for you at my restaurant. I express myself through food.
I get that.
Why don't you want to talk about going back to law school?
I want to be an artist, Dad. I want beauty in my life.
It is said that Dante met Beatrice here. One of the most beautiful love stories of all time. Let's keep our eyes on the good things and the good food.
I think we can be something great. We need more than
love, love. Today we start our new lives together. Nothing is holding us back. Only dreams ahead.
Lino's reinventing Thanksgiving.
Oh, good. Because if there's anything Texans love, it's different shit.
Are you still on that starter job?
It's not been easy for me in this country.
I'm a chef who can't make a living cooking for people.
Lino, what happened?
This is not my home. The city has no center.
In a city where there is no center,
I'm your center.
We can do this. You did it your way, and I am proud of you.
Italians love a good love story, and ours is for the ages.
You could see From Scratch on Netflix. And we do have a Black Diamond this week with Pearl. Trapped on her family's isolated farm, Pearl must tend to her ailing father under the bitter and overbearing watch of her devout mother. Lusting for a glamorous life like she's seen in the movies, Pearl finds her ambitions, temptations, and repressions all colliding. T. West prequel to X mixes the slasher genre with gorgeous Technicolor-inspired cinematography and gives his lead, Mia Goth, a larger spotlight to show off her multifaceted talents as an actress. Here's the trailer. You can see Pearl on Apple TV, Google Play, Vudu, and Amazon. And to conclude our countdown to Halloween as October wraps up, we've compiled a collection of our top horror movies of all time. From old classics like Frankenstein to cult classics like The Wicker Man and new favorites such as Get Out, this list compiles the best and the scariest of the genre. Enjoy these picks and have a happy Halloween. And that's a wrap for the iGems TV Guide this week. Hope you enjoy these selections and have a great holiday weekend. Until next time, the search is over.